Welcome back guys. So I am going to start with by function, and we will see that how by function is different from the function which we have seen that earlier. So name says that by functions, which means this by functions will accept two input, whereas the function will accept one input, right? So let's see that how by functions work. So just write here by. And if you go here, this is also available in the Java util function package. So you click on that, right? So what is this T, U and R? We'll go inside and we will try to understand. Press control, click on by function. So when you'll go inside that, and if you read about this, you will understand this represents a function that accept two arguments and produces the result. Okay. What result it will produce? It will produce the third object what you supply. So first two, if you look at the type of first argument, the second U is the type of second argument, and the third is the type of third argument. So basically this is also a functional interface which takes three argument, and it has a method called apply. So if you look at here, whatever first two object you have, on that your apply implementations will get processed. Whatever implementations you write for the apply, it will get processed, and your result is going to be the final object what you supplied. R is the final object, right, in the by functions. And it also has a method called and then, right? So basically you can club more than one by function. And one more important things on the by functions, when you do and then, you club with the function. So the by functions you can club with multiple function by using and then. We will try to understand how this guy will work and how we can perform and then. So let's write one by function. So here let me do one thing. Let me write this guy accept integer. Second argument is also it takes, let's say, integer, and it produces integer, right? Simple example. So this is my by function. I will write add by function. Okay. So basically this guy accepts two number, number one comma number two. It will accept two number and it will sum these two number, right? So num one plus num two. And again, this by function has a return type. Okay. It has a return type. So this is your one functions. Now I will write one more functions. One more by functions I will write. This guy will multiply. Multiply. That's it. Right, and I'm going to write, so this is my two by functions. I'm going to write one function, just a function. So in functions, you know that you have only two object as an input. So if you'll go to the function, press control, go inside the functions. So if you look at this, okay, sorry, I came to the wrong location. This is not the functions which I'm looking for. So, okay, there is no import, by the way. So let me correct first this name. So multiply function. And now I have to import. Yeah, see here. It is also available in the Java util function. So we need to import this one. Now press control, go to the functions. If you go here, you can see that it takes two input. So basically it accepts only one input and produces the result. So what result it will produce? The second object R. Okay. So it also has apply method, and whatever you write implementations for the apply, your output is going to be second object. Your output is going to be second object. What does mean by that? This I have already covered. Again, I will give you idea. So I'll supply integer, I will do some processing on the integer, and finally my output is going to be the integer. So here I cannot supply two number, okay? What I can do, I cannot write like this, I can do into 5, okay? Now let's test this and we will try to understand how these things works. So static, intentionally I am writing a static so that I don't have to create the object. Then I can write in system output println add by consumer dot accept dot, it has a method called apply. So apply, I will apply 20 30, okay, right? And then this is my first by function. In my second by function, I will just call 20 30, and I will write one more where what I will do, I will write this by function dot and then function which I have shown you, right, dot apply. Okay, so when you go inside the by functions, you have something called and then also. So this and then, what is the input? Input is the function. So you can see that all three we are going to test, and we'll see that how this works. So if I will do run as Java applications, you can see that the answer is 50, 600 and 250. So how the answers is coming? So if you look at the first, when we did the sum of 20, 30, it comes 50. Second one, we did a multiply 20 into 30, 600, right, which is 600. Then why 250 later? Because the 250 why it came is we did add, right? We did add and then we did a multiply. So how this works is when we did add, what was the output? 50, right? So whatever output was from and by functions, so this function output went input to this function, okay? The functions of add by functions output went input to this. So number one was 50, because first sum was performed by using this. So 50 came input to this function. So 50 into 5, how much it is? It is 250. Clear? Like how 250, we got it, right? So that's how guys it works, right? Now let me look at some more example. So here in this example, what I will show you, let's say we have one by functions and which will do addition, okay, which will add two number. And then let me tell you here some unique things. So let's say you have something called integer, okay, again you are adding integer and you are expecting output as an integer. Clear? What you have, a comma b, right? And then you are doing that a plus b. So let's say this is your by function. Guys, sometimes I do mistake, instead of by functions I say by consumer. So because these topics are very correlated, right? So try to understand. So this is by function, right? Now what I will do, I'm going to call this in the try catch. So since this is my function, I can call dot and then, right, null, okay. I'm going to do try dot and then null. Let me catch that. Exception e, and here let me print the exception. Clear? Right? If I run this, what is the output it will come? Your output will come as a null pointer exceptions, because in AND then when you actually write null, so basically it will give you the null pointer, because it is whatever was the output from this by functions, it went input to these functions. So you cannot write functions as a null. When you write functions as a null, you will get null pointer exceptions, because it will try to perform some operations and you will get null pointer. So people can ask you in the interview, like, is it possible, can I write one by functions dot add then and then null? You say that it will throw null pointer exceptions. I will show you one more example where, let's say, same by function, right, and you are trying to do add is equal to, you are trying to do add dot, let's say, and then, okay, and you are writing one normal function, so a arrow a divided by 0. So basically what will happen here, ideally this guy will throw arithmetic exception, right? So if I in system output println on this add, if I will do dot apply and if I will do 20 tab 30, what will happen, what we should get, we should get arithmetic exceptions. So you can see that arithmetic exceptions is coming. The reason is, when you have a by function, okay, the first by functions, and then you are performing and then, right? So go inside the and then, press control, go to the and then. What is the return type of and then? The return type of and then is basically v. V is nothing but, if you look at this v, so what is the v? V is the object, right? So here, if you look at this extends v, right, this is the by consumer inside the functions and this guy extends v, so this is also a object, right? So basically what object it is, if you want to see that, let me show you. If you want to see that what is the object, let me show you. If I'll just change the reference here, add one, and if I'll just mouse over, click on create local variable, see, this is also a by function. This is also a by function. So the return type of two and, like, one by function and then and then another by and then and another functions. So basically this is the function, guys. So what I have written here is, if I have to show you, I can write in the simple way. Simple lambda expressions I can write like this, so that you will not get any confusion. What I have written there is, I have just written divide is equal to, you know that function will take only one input and it will process the record, and whatever object you have supplied, the second one, the return type is going to be the second object. So I'm just doing like this, right? The same thing, whatever you have written here, the same, like, you can see that this is your functions. Same thing I'm writing inside, because and then will accept functions, right? So by functions dot and then functions return type is a by functions. So you know that on by functions we have apply method, so when we will call that, we are getting that arithmetic exceptions. So you understood how by functions works. The major difference between by function and function is, by functions will take two input data and your output would be the third object in your by functions, whereas functions will accept one input data and your output of the functions is second object in your function. Now both has a method called apply, okay? Even the function has a method called apply. If you go inside the function, you have apply method, you can see that. Even your by function has a method called apply. When you go inside the by functions, you have a method called and then. So basically one by functions can be added with another functions, because the input is the functions, Whereas if you'll go inside the function, here your and then will actually, you can put more than one functions, you can combine more than one functions by using and then. Clear? So with this, I will close the video for by functions, and in next video, I will talk about by predicate, right? So we have seen that, as of now, we have seen that function, consumer, by consumer. Now I spoke about by functions. Now I'm going to talk about by predicate, and we'll see that how by predicate works. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this.